Assalamu alaikum everyone. So I remember few of you asking me the steps of the complete NGF application, and I don't know, sometimes I was not able to fulfill the request that was, you know, requested to me. So since I have my album with me now, I thought why not discuss the cases. So I'll be starting with the most basic case, that is the balanced NGF. So we'll be going through the steps of the complete NGF application, and this is going to be a new style video, so I hope that you guys like it. Let me know in the comment section below. I avoid usually coming on screen. I don't know why. I don't feel comfortable, but still, let's try. Let's experiment this style of video as well. So we are starting with the characterized balanced denture. Okay. So obviously we are going to start with the pre-op extraoral images, intraoral images as well. And then you make the diagnostic impression. Now, diagnostic impression and primary impression can be different. Like if after diagnostic impression and making the diagnostic cast, you realize that there are certain pre-prosthetic surgeries that are required. There are tori, retained root, etc. So in that case, after the pre-prosthetic surgery is done, you again make another impression, and that will be a primary impression. So that is the basic difference between the diagnostic and the primary impression. So here in this case, like, this was the diagnostic impression, no pre-prosthetic adjustments or modifications were needed. So that same diagnostic cast was used as a primary cast, okay? And of course, after that, we are going to make the custom tray over it, okay? I have already a video on my channel on how to make it. And then we do the peripheral tracing or water molding, and here light body was used. A silicone light body was used to take the wash impression. And then we do boxing of the impression. This is plaster pumice boxing. Then we have the master cast, right? And then the rims are fabricated on it. Now, to fabricate the rims, we are initially following the ideal guidelines of fabricating the rims, right? So that will be done. And after this step, we're going to try it in the patient's mouth. We're going to adjust the lip fullness first and then the lip visibility. Then we're going to use a Fox plane. And then we are going to have a face bow, you know, record. So that is a tentative jaw record we're doing, because we are going to verify it again by putting traces and all. So here in this case, you can see that I have used putty and the dentulous fork. Actually, I'll just zoom in. Why I am not zooming in, I'm not sure. Okay. So here I have used a dentulous fork. Okay. So what happens is, when we are using an edentulous fork for this, we have to make little adjustments to the rim after we remove that fork. So here I have used a dentulous fork, and then tentative jaw record was complete here. Then we are going to attach tracers. Tracer attachment is another big topic that I would like to cover in a separate video. But here we basically have 4 die pins, which is used to hold this assembly together when we're using a split cast method. So how to make a split cast? First, we are going to, you know, make notches on the master cast, and then use a boxing wax, and then pour another layer in die stone. Okay. And then when you, you know, do this face bow transfer, we're going to mount the upper cast. Then attaching tracer, it has to be parallel to the plane, right? To the allotragus line. It has to be parallel. This arrangement can be any way, both going upwards or both going downwards. Doesn't really matter. The thing which matters is that we don't need to have any kind of interferences. So after you put the central bearing plate, I've not shown the central bearing plate here. When you put the central bearing plate, make sure that the central bearing point is in the center. That's why we say that balancing cannot be done in class 2, class 3 situation, because it's not possible in those cases to have that, you know, centralization of the forces. Okay, so after this, we have attached the tracer, and then we train the patient to get this arrowhead tracing. Then we make 2 records, 1 centric record and 1 protrusive record. Another debatable topic is whether the protrusive record should be perforated or not. There are various schools of thought, but what I feel is they should be perforated, because obviously the patient, in an idle condition, the patient is actually biting down on the point and then protruding forward. So it should be perforated. Both should be perforated. Okay. Centric record, obviously, there is no doubt about it. It should be perforated only because the vertical has to be maintained. Then after this, we are using the centric record to check whether the tentative jaw record was correct. If it is correct, we are going to take the protrusive record and we are going to program the articulator, write the H and the L value. L is calculated by a formula. L is equal to H by 8 plus 12. After programming, we are going for anterior teeth setting and try in the patient, and then we are going to program the incisal guidance. Basically, you on the articulator, you bring the teeth edge to edge, and then you set the anterior posterior inclination, okay, this way. And then lateral excursion, the canine and canine will touch. In that case, you have to, you know, make sure that the platform actually is touching the incisal door. It should not lift. So both sides, you have to adjust the lateral wings also. And after that, we are going to do the posterior teeth setting, right? We have to make sure that obviously the lower posterior teeth are lying on the crest of the ridge, or it can be lingual also, not buccal. In any case, it will lead to instability. And this is the posterior try-in, then the processing, lab remounting. So this was all the steps of complete dental fabrication in brief. If you are an undergraduate student, you'll be skipping all these tracing and all this part. This is for MDS. It's kind of hectic, takes a little while to get hang of it. We'll discuss this one by one. So I hope you found this video helpful. I'll see you in the next video. Allah Hafiz.